So, welcome everybody back to Isha's Taxis. So we did pretty well in the first episode, so let's see if we can continue that success. See, most of the chapters we got 3 stars on. Or at least more than one, so hopefully we'll continue that with this one. Do the final 5.
Thank goodness, a simple fare. Passenger had a breakdown and needs a lift home. Off you go.
Are we in this standard? No, we're not. Well, initially we were in the standard OS in there.
Here's the pickup location. It should feel like a nice lazy holiday after that last one. Just to be clear, you absolutely cannot slow down or take a holiday.
So yeah, hopefully this will be a fairly simple one. Obviously it all depends on what the customer wants. This is a mostly well tuned up and upgraded car. Not something I'd personally make out of a standard Austin, but it's fairly decent.
Park it here, the passenger shouldn't be far. Now, you needn't worry about their car. I've already organized a breakdown service to come and collect. Which reminds me, the photocopy is broken, which means I have to print the invoices myself, which means I need to... Anyway, that's not for you to worry about. There's the passenger, off you go.
Yeah, don't worry, I wasn't worrying about your photocopy.
Thanks very much, but how did you get here so quick? You didn't know my car was going to break down before I did you?
Of course I did. I'm psychic.
It's always like this. Just when you need to get somewhere, a light comes on and the car stops working. It's almost as if it knows I need to go somewhere and is actively working against me. Do you think that's what's actually happening? No, of course not. Fantastic. I might keep Aisha's taxis on the speed dial and just get rid of the car. It's always been a bit of a banger anyway.
Be interesting to know what car she was in. But I like how they won't say, because obviously they don't want to annoy any manufacturer. But we've got 3 stars, which is a good start to this first 5 of chapters that we're doing. Hopefully we can keep up that success. Get some money out of that, which is always good. Nice big 50k. More money is always useful, obviously, in a game where you spend your money on pretty much everything. Right, let's see what the next one has in store for us.
Yes, hello, you're back. What did you make of that last fare?
Easy peasy.
Excellent, wonderful. Don't tell me there's no time. I have another passenger waiting for you.
Oh, we're off-roading now, are we?
Pickup location is set. It's a bit rural, but I suppose it might be someone coming into town for the day.
Take big jumps, that's for sure. Still easily drove into trees though. Oh dear.
In 400 yards.
Doesn't like all of the bumps of the jumps though, as you can see by easily rolling over. Doesn't bode well for having to go off-road for the fare. damn houses. Always getting in the way of your drive.
Park there, I suppose. Good a place as any.
She's really rather cynical, isn't she?
Huh. We're not going off to town. The destination seems to be in the middle of nowhere as well. Never mind. We don't need to know why they're going, do we? Just where.
Though indeed.
You will be careful taking the taxi across country, won't you?
You make it sound like I haven't done it before.
Sorry to bother you, but my tractor's on the blink, and I'm sorry if this is unorthodox, but I know every blade of grass on this farm, and I'm a little set in my way, so you'll follow my shortcut precisely, please. Straight across that field to start.
It hardly looked like you were dressed at a farm, but whatever, I don't discriminate. Oh dear. I do hate trees though, I won't get in the way.
Wasn't that a good shortcut? Apologies if it was a little bumpy. A few new blades of grass I'm not yet familiar with, I think.
Damn, only got 2 stars. Probably is a quicker way to do that, but yeah, it's just about trial and error on that kind of mission. Because obviously you've got to take the shortest route possible, but one that's also quick and easy to navigate. And my route clearly wasn't that. But could be worse, could have only got the 1 star. Just a shame that we couldn't get the 3, really. Right. 3rd chapter of this episode.
Next passenger has already been waiting at the pickup location for 20 minutes. What are you waiting for? Go! Just because they're overeager doesn't mean we can be late.
Off-road one in the same direction by the looks of things.
Pickup is at Mortimer Gardens, but there's no destination or route. That's odd. In 200 yards.
Well, I think we've realised by now that a lot of our customers are hardly the normal type.
Turn right. Recalculating route. In 100 yards, turn right.
This doesn't handle a lot well on the road, to be honest. That off-road suspension has made a car that was already quite tall all the taller, making it a little bit bumpy, would it? A little bit uncontrollable. Trees everywhere, damn it. Probably should have stuck to the road, but then again, this car doesn't like that, obviously. Seems like we've got a tree magnet on our car. Don't think it takes into account how long you take to get to the initial destination in terms of the stars. brakes certainly aren't the best either.
This is the place. You better pull up.
I have done.
I hope this isn't another one of those funny ones who doesn't actually need to go anywhere but just wants us to do some sort of ridiculous stunt. I blame Joel for this.
Right, now I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. I don't actually need to go anywhere. You've got a reputation around here as some sort of boss driver. Well, it's gonna take a lot more than a reputation to impress me. Head for the Mortimer Gardens and bring the drift.
Yeah, it's just another one of those silly ones that doesn't want to go anywhere. Using a taxi cab like a roller coaster. Avoid the ruins. Oh dear, damn it. There's a lot of points there that I've just lost. And 25,000 isn't exactly a difficult target, but it is annoying when you lose a ridiculous amount of points in the process of trying to get to that target. But that's where risk and reward comes into it on these kind of things. What? How did that... That was a load of BS, to be fair. Yeah, it's annoying sometimes that the hit detection sometimes registers, you know, if you went through a destructible wall a bit too fast or a bit too much of it, it ends up taking it away from you as well. I've had that happen to me. That's the first time that landing on top of a tree that is destructible has lost me the required amount of points that I just got. And we'll do it again, easily get the 25,000, but I don't want to get any more than that to get the 2 or 3 stars.
Driving you just did.
I'd have got more than one star there if I'd have got those points that I initially had. That's proper annoying, that is. Again, yeah, the hit detection on certain objects with cars is really rather off at times. Yeah, it's annoying. Less so when you're just, you know, racing around and stuff and collecting points on the fly, but really annoying when, you know, you're actually trying to complete a mission or something. That's something I'm definitely going to do in my own time. Alright, nonetheless, let's move on to the next one. At the end of this episode, we will look at all the targets that we had to get for each chapter. Especially for the ones that we didn't get 4 free stars on.
Back, are you? Well, I'll have you know, while you've been quite literally spinning your wheels, I've been trying to run an actual passenger service. I'm not sure if... Oh, what am I talking about? Isha's taxis comes to a standstill without you. Sorry, but can we please get back to basics? Taking people from point A to point B. Very, very quickly. For me?
Sure.
Well, Next pickup location is set. Away we go.
The fact that you've only got one person doing the driving is doesn't make real business sense, to be honest. But then again, neither does running a car that, you know, has to be modified drastically between different fares. Especially when you consider these kind of ones aren't going to be all that economically friendly. I don't even want to know how much fuel it will take to run this vehicle in this version.
In 400 yards.
Especially since rotary engines do kind of eat up a lot of oil. Thank you so much.
I only spoke to the lady for a moment, but she sounds absolutely lovely. Just needs a quick hop over to Edinburgh to visit her sister in the suburbs.
Might want to get out of the rain.
Apparently they like to watch motor racing together.
Right, love? Oh, you're not one of these drivers from Horizon, are you? I'm from a family of big racing fans myself. My sister and I have been following all the action at the festival. You couldn't put your foot down a bit for me, could you?
I can try. Although the rain does make this a tricky vehicle to drive.
400 yards. Turn right.
Luckily with this kind of thing, I don't think you actually have to bank the skill that you're seeking. Just a case of it registering.
Turn right. In 200 yards, turn left. Turn left. In 200 yards, turn left. Turn left.
Miles an hour.
That's not bad, but it looks a lot faster on the telly. Can you speed it up a bit?
How much faster you do want it? I'm going 200 miles an hour in a taxi, it's all too slow.
Come on now, love. I want you to really blow my air back. Can you do that for me?
I think there's a certain amount of skills that you need to get 3 stars.
At the roundabout,
over the roundabout.
The second exit. In 400 yards, turn right.
This is amazing. Everything looks so blurry right now.
I think we might have got 3 stars. Oh crap.
Turn around.
Forgot about doing that.
Do so.
See, I'm so used to all the other like missions and chapters and things being you're just blasting
Thank
through
you.
The destination.
Good luck racing at the festival. I'll be cheering for you. Wait till I tell my sister I had a ride in a real race car. She'll say it was only a taxi, but you and I know differently, don't we, love?
Sure do. But luckily it was about how many skills you had that you needed the 3 stars and not the time, so we weren't penalised for our shoot over. Nice hefty amount of money out of that though. And obviously plenty of influence. Leveled up twice over. 2 wheel spins in the bag. Let's do this one though. Oh yes, nice 40 grand load. I would have preferred the 140, but a nice amount of money is still a nice amount of money. Not sure if this is the last one or not, so it might well be, to be honest. Close your eyes, here it is. Let's see what this final chapter is in store for us. The
okay.
Big one.
Okay, calm down. Where to start? I've been working on a bit of a business diversification that I haven't told you about because I didn't want to worry you. I've managed to get my hands on a limousine. Damon at the festival, such a nice guy. And I thought we could offer high-speed luxury group fares. But I really should have asked first, since you'll have to do all the driving.
Well, you better have done this car up, and it looks like you have. Not front-wheel drive still, is it? No, it's rear-wheel drive, I think, now, thankfully. But adding rear-wheel drive, though, added a lot of weight to this car, considering, you know, such a long vehicle. Which is why limousines tend to be front-wheel drive nowadays. And all the old ones didn't used to be. So anyway, this is called the big one. I imagine this is going to be quite a long one.
Just think, if this works, we could be Isha's luxury limos. Got them? All right. I'll put the next pickup into your sat nav. Quick as you can.
Here's a passenger.
And the bloke
Let's
looks
go.
At the mechanic and says, "I'd love to, but that's not my car." What do you reckon?
A damn radio. Well, it's not a long one, so it's just called the big one because it's, you know, the first venture into limousines.
Well, not much point doing the rest of the joke now you've heard the punchline. Sorry, name's James, by the way. Just warming up for this gig in Edinburgh. Hope you don't mind.
No, I don't mind at all. I'm more concentrating on the fact that we're crashing into a cliff. That is not going to help our time.
See, there's so many people in town for the Horizon Festival, I figure I'd better do some car jokes, but I don't know any. Do you? You're a driver. Nothing, eh? See, this is exactly what I mean. Joking about cars with this Horizon lot is like joking about burgers with a bunch of cows. Nothing, eh? You know, for a cabbie, you certainly don't say much.
I'm not a cabbie anymore, I'm a limo driver. Different whole thing, quite frankly.
In 400 yards, you will arrive at your destination.
Well, I'll be surprised if we get 3 stars after having our crash.
Anyhow, I think we're picking up my mate Charlie next. Maybe he's got something good.
Oh, we're picking up more than one person. I didn't realise.
You made the pickup? Oh, thank goodness. So, what are they like? Are they funny?
Not really.
No, don't tell me. There's no time. I've updated your route to the next pickup point. Better get to it.
I have both of these chattering in the back now.
You want to know how slow my car is? I'll tell you how slow my car is. It's so slow that... Oh, hey, hiya. You all right, Jess? How you doing? You got your car material ready for gig?
Not really, Charlie. What you got? Sounds like you're working on something.
Yeah, hey, yeah, listen to this. My car
subtitles
is so
crapped
slow
out
that when I drive it, it often makes me late for stuff.
That's not very good, Charlie.
Nah, it's not, is it? As slow as... Blimey. This one driving won't be much help. This taxi's quicker than me mama, bingo night. Here, we're picking up Harry next. Let's see if he's got something.
In 400 yards, turn right.
Where we're going, we don't need roads.
In 400 yards, turn right. Turn right.
Another person? Who is it this time? Another guy. And he's out
okay,
in the rain as well.
Confirmed, thank heavens. When it comes to waiting, turns out these comedians don't have much of a sense of humor. Next pickup should be on your sat-nav now. Step on it.
Yeah, I will, but not too much, because it is raining.
All right, everyone. What you call a driver with no sense of direction?
Hey, take it easy, Harry. We don't want to upset our nice Horizon driver in the front here. Besides, I know the punchline to that one. It's rubbish.
Oh, you do? Could tell me, then. I'm still working on the blooming thing. How about you, Jess? What have you got?
A whole lot of nothing. Not a lot of time to come up with anything better. The rate this taxi's going.
All right, how about this? What do you call a comedian who has to get a job as a taxi driver?
I'd call that you and me, mate, if we don't come up with something before we get to Edinburgh.
Okay, okay, calm down. We're picking up Poppy next. She's bound to have something.
Well, this limo does handle. It's not as fast as I was expecting it to. It would be interesting to see the stats on these cars, but unfortunately you're not able to.
400 yards. Turn sharp left. In 200 yards, turn right.
Is this the final passenger?
Pickup confirmed. It's working. It's actually working. I can't believe it's actually working. Final passenger is down
no,
in Broadway.
Next one.
We can do this. Come on.
Right, one more passenger and then probably a destination to get to.
Hi, everyone. Jeff, Charlie, Harry. Wow, car jokes are hard, right? How about this? Why did the Horizon drive across the road?
Yep, we're doomed.
Steady on. I've got some other stuff I've been working on. How many Horizon drivers does it
watch
take?
You can't see
to
them
like
actually in
tried
there.
That already. The answer is one. Tech down in the auto show named Dave changed both headlights on my car in about 2 seconds flat.
All right, relax, everyone. We're going to pick up Jack before we head to the gig. He's absolutely hilarious. He'll definitely have something.
not from the UK, probably marvelling at all the different accents you keep hearing on this game.
In 400 yards, turn right.
But they aren't too difficult to understand.
Turn right. In 200 yards, turn left. Turn left.
Try and find shortcuts when doing these kind of things, but sometimes it's just easiest to use the row that you're actually given. Especially for this one, doesn't look like there's much room for a shortcut at all, to be honest. I'm probably wrong. Just wing it through these trees. Idea how they're going to rate the 3 stars on this, but like I said, we'll look at what the objectives were. Find a passenger.
We're so close now. Careful with this last passenger. He's the headline act. Not sure why. He didn't seem very funny on the phone.
Hello, Jess, Charlie, Harry, Poppy. Fancy running into all of you. Wow, this taxi's quite fast, isn't it? Are we all excited for the gig? I know I am.
Jack, you have to help us. We're dying here.
Seriously, Jack, with all these Horizon people in town, if we can't come up with a decent car joke, we're gonna get laughed off the stage.
Yeah, like, not in a good way. Come on, Jack, we're all counting on you. What have you got for us? Don't worry, I've got it under control. You ready? When is a car not a car? When it turns into a corner. All right, it's going to be a great show, everyone. Thank you very
so
much,
funny.
Driver.
The light's not telling us how far the destination is, but we haven't got long to get there. Let's take a punt on going this way. Oh dear, maybe the wrong decision. No, come on, get out of there. So this is when maybe the off-road option isn't the best option. Come on, you can make it, Limo. I doubt we gain any time there. Stick to the road unless we can see an obvious shortcut. Even though that did look like an obvious one, I clearly didn't realise that there was a river down there. If I did know that, I wouldn't have bothered. To be honest, it's probably rating us on the 3 stars on this final one. See how they could do it with all the other ones. Let's go. Less than 3 minutes. Wish this had a higher top speed. I guess Yes, it's partly reduced because of the rear wing, which I guess at the end of the day is necessary for handling. Just gotta keep the speed up at a good average and we should do it. It's annoying barely being able to see how far away we are. Come on. 40 seconds.
Made it. Isha's taxis is about to go nationwide. We're busier than ever, and I still don't have help in the office, and I'm not stressed. I know we'll get there, and everything will be fine. I believe I have you to thank for this breakthrough. So, I won't need you to do so much driving now. I can manage from here.
Good to know. But yeah, I figured we wouldn't get the 3 stars, but I was surprised that we got the 2. But yeah, it'll be interesting to see how fast it actually had to go on that final chapter and the other ones that we didn't get a full 3 stars on. I will be annoyed if we didn't have to get all that much for that skill point one, because obviously it wasn't my fault that we lost the skill chain.
Isha sounded relieved on the phone, which, if you know Isha, is pretty major. So, nice job. I'll call you when she gets in touch again.
Yeah, the skill points one was not my fault, but yeah, nonetheless, let's see what we had to get. So on the first one we had to get a minute 15, on the country roads one we had to get a minute 50, rain check one we had to be 1 minute 10, shortest fare ever we had to be doing 205 mile an hour, door to door 1 minute 5 seconds, the skill points one we needed 220,000 points. So maybe I had a chance of getting that, but yeah, it all depends on whether or not we would have got that skill chain higher than we did. Then the big one, 4 minutes 5 seconds, weren't all that far off that. If we hadn't have obviously had that off-road incident, would have been alright. So yeah, there we go. So yeah, unfortunately not 3 stars on everything there. We only got 3 stars on, well, ironically, 3 different chapters, but yeah, obviously room for improvement there, and once you do get all of the stars for each chapter, you obviously do get rewarded with your Austin FX for taxi, which I've already got via a wheel spin, but it is difficult to get it via a wheel spin or an auction house, so this is definitely probably the easiest way of getting one, but yeah, I just got lucky in terms of the wheel spin, quite frankly. Nonetheless, there we go, that's the end of it for Isha's taxis. So yeah, pretty fun business one. I'm glad that they're adding these kind of things in, because obviously you get more money per day for completing it, and then obviously you get money via doing the chapters as well and wheel spins and the like. So yeah, well worth going through if you haven't already, and yeah, I look forward to seeing if there's any more of this coming in the future. Nonetheless, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.